So let me pick up where we left in the last video. So I'm interested in deriving this maximum efficiency limit for a solar energy conversion. And this is sometime also known as the Landsberg limit. And I had basically, mapped out all the energy and the associated entropy fluxes. The energy fluxes are represented in this color red. The work is represented in green, and all the entropy fluxes are represented in blue over here. And I had taken into account this factor of 4/3, which comes into play whenever there's a radiative process involved in the energy transfer. And I had also taken into account this emission, which has to take place from this cell, because this cell is essentially at a finite temperature TC, so it will emit out radiation as a black body as well. So now this places me in a good condition to derive this Landsberg limit. And again, I'll stick to the basics. So I'll just use the first and second law of thermodynamics to derive this limit. So let me write down the first law of thermodynamics. And this basically says the energy is conserved in this conversion process. So I can write down this energy conservation as essentially this energy, which is energy flux, which is coming from the sun. This must be equal to the rate at which work is produced plus the rate at which heat is emitted out from the system plus the flux associated, energy flux associated with this radiation coming from this cell. Now the second law of thermodynamics, it essentially relates these fluxes of entropy, and I can write again the incoming flux, which I now know is incoming flux due to the energy of the sun, which has now I know has a factor of 4/3, and this is my incoming flux, plus I'm going to add to this the flux or the entropy which was generated in this conversion, and that is going to be equal to the entropy which was given out. So the entropy which was associated with this black body radiation coming from the cell, and that is essentially related to this energy flux of the radiation from the cell divided by the temperature of the cell. And again, there's a factor of 4/3 because there's a radiative process over here. And then I'm going to add with that the energy, the entropy flux associated with this heat which was given out. And again, I'm interested in finding the overall efficiency of this conversion, which I can again represent by eta. And this is my work divided by the energy coming from the sun. So I can make use of this first law and substitute for W over here. So I'll substitute for W as ES, energy coming from the sun, minus the energy radiated out by the cell, minus the heat. And this divided by ES. So this is the efficiency which I can get from this conversion process, and this is essentially now equal to 1 minus EC by ES minus Q by ES. And now if I look at this term, this basically compares the energy flux coming from the cell divides it by the energy flux coming from the sun. And I know that I've treated both the cell and the sun as black bodies. So the energy flux which are coming from these black bodies, I can make use of the Stefan-Boltzmann law. I can say the energy flux which is coming from the sun, it's proportional to the fourth power of the temperature of the sun. Similarly, the energy flux which is going to be coming out from the cell is proportional to the fourth power of the temperature of the cell. And this is basically, I'm just writing down the Stefan-Boltzmann law. So if I take these two equations and then take a division of these energy flux, that leaves me with a term which is proportional to the fourth power of the temperature of the cell and divided by the fourth power of the temperature of the sun. Okay, so now the only term I am left to evaluate is this Q divided by ES. And I'm going to make use of the second law of thermodynamics to derive this. So I see that there's a Q term over here, and there's an ES term over here. So I'm going to multiply, or I'm going to divide this, both the left-hand side and the right-hand side, by ES. And I see a TA term over here. So I'm going to multiply both the left-hand side and the right-hand side by TA. So let me do that. So I'm going to basically multiply this by TA, multiply the left-hand side also by TA, and then divide both the left-hand and right-hand side by ES. And let me put a dot over here. I forgot to put a dot over here. So sometimes I use this dot on top of this letter, and what it is used to represent is basically this dot represents the flux. So let's say Q is denoting heat, so Q dot is denoting the flux of heat. Sometimes I forget to put them on, but throughout this analysis, keep in mind that all these terms have a dot associated on top of them. The convention that I like to use. So let me simplify it. So now what I get on my right hand side is this term Q by ES, and then I get this extra term over here, which is plus 4/3 EC divided by ES into TA divided by TC. And on the left hand side, again, I get a term which is 4/3 TA by TS. And then I get this extra term, which is due to the entropy generated. And what I want to do is process, what I want to do is minimize this value of Q by ES. And this equation, it's clear that value will be minimum if this term goes to zero. So if there's no extra entropy generated in this process. To minimize this Q by ES term, I essentially equate this term to zero. And now what I get is the value that I want, which is Q by ES, it's essentially equal to 4/3 into TA by TS minus, again, 4/3 TA by TC. And again, I see this term, which is relating the energy flux from the cell and dividing it by the energy flux of the sun. And just like the way I did it over here, I can, the ratio of these two fluxes is related to the temperature of the cell and the temperature of the sun, and given by a fourth power of these temperatures. So now I have this equation which relates my Q by ES, and I can plug that into my efficiency equation. So if I do that, then the value of efficiency that I get is essentially the value of efficiency is now 1 minus TC by TS to the power of 4. And then I subtract this term out from this equation. So I substitute for minus QS by ES over here. So that gives me minus 4/3 TA by TS, and then a plus 4/3 TA by TC, and then TC by TS raised to the power 4. So I can take this term common between between these two terms, and then what I get is essentially efficiency is given by this equation, where I can take plus TC by TS raised to power 4, and then I get 4/3 TA by TC minus 1. So I've combined these two terms and taken the TC by TS raised to the power 4 common out. So now if I look at this equation, this basically has the temperature of the ambient, which is fixed. It has the temperature of the sun, which is fixed as well. And but also it has this temperature of the cell, and that is mostly coming into play in this term. So if I increase the temperature of the cell, this term increases, but on the other hand, this term decreases. And if it decreases, in fact, this term becomes less than 1, then this whole thing is going to subtract from the efficiency. So in fact, you know, you can take a minimum of this term, and in fact it turns out to be minimum when the temperature of the cell is equal to the temperature of the ambient. And that kind of makes sense, because you know, when the cell is at the temperature of the ambient, it would you know, the energy flux associated with due to radiation from the cell would be minimized. So it kind of makes sense that you know, at this value of cell temperature, we would get the maximum efficiency. So if I plug this value of TC, or the temperature of the cell, is equal to the ambient temperature, then this equation essentially reduces to 1 minus 4 by 3 TA by TS. And then if I substitute for TC equal to TA, then this term becomes 4 by 3. And if I subtract 1 from it, what I'm left with is 1 by 3. So I'm left with 1 by 3 TC by TS raised to the power, or in fact, you know, let me not write TC. So I'll write it as TA by TS raised to the power 4. And this is what is called as the Landsberg limit, and it's an important limit. And let me put it in a box over here. And this gives me the maximum ceiling of the efficiency that I can get from this conversion. And if I put the value of TA to be 300 Kelvin, and a value of TS to be 6000 Kelvin, so this gives me an efficiency of Landsberg limit, which corresponds to 93.3%.